What's up everyone, your friendly neighborhood Wanzi Guy here, back with another trailer reaction, and today we are going to go ahead and look at Masters of the Universe Revelation, the new Masters of the Universe animated series coming to Netflix in July. Now, originally I was introduced to Masters of the Universe via the live action film. I know it's not the best way to be introduced to it, but I was very young when it came out. I enjoyed it back then, I still enjoy watching it now. I then followed on watching the original series and then tried to get hold of the later series that happened in the early 2000s. Unfortunately, that's very difficult to find in South Africa, so I only managed to see a few episodes. I didn't manage to watch the whole series. So this is definitely something I really have been looking forward to. When I originally found out about it via Kevin Smith, which is my personal filmmaking hero, who I followed since the days of Clerks and Dogma and Red State, all the way up until his more recent weirder things like Tusk and Yoga Hoses, which I still enjoy all of it. And then finding out from him that the animation was being done by the team that did Castlevania, so to expect the action sequences and the animation to just be very crisp, very clean, which is something that is lacking in a lot of animated series these days. So I have no idea what to expect of this, just that I know it's probably going to look beautiful. We'll see obviously how many of the original characters we can identify. So without further ado, let us go ahead and take a look.
Time after time, you try to take this castle, but you will never succeed, Skeletor.
Grayskull.
Call your champion.
Oh, Mark Hamill, you beauty. Man at arms. You can live. Beast man. Oh, I love this track. I'm actually getting chills. Of course. Animation is so clean. Oh, this just looks beautiful.
I need a hero.
Oh yes, all the way, yes. Okay, that was just stunningly beautiful. Just clean animation. I know it, at least for this trailer, doesn't have an original theme song, but the track that they used fits perfectly. Of course, that iconic line, "I have the power," it's probably one of the most iconic catchphrases of any superhero ever, because I do classify He-Man as a superhero. And that transformation, that very distinct transformation between Prince Adam and He-Man, which if I'm not mistaken, in the earlier animated series, the original series, the distinction wasn't that much. Prince Adam was still quite a big dude. He basically just took his clothes off and had his He-Man outfit on. That's basically what happened. With this, there was a very distinct transformation between him and He-Man. So very much a Shazam situation. So yes, I'm extremely excited for this. And again, just hearing Mark Hamill's voice and having a laugh that is, again, distinct but different from the Joker's is also perfect. I mean, that man is just not just film royalty, but voice acting royalty as well. So they couldn't have picked a perfect person to portray Skeletor. Again, I can't go over enough about how beautiful and clean the animation was. We did just see action sequences, basically, so there isn't much really to say about where the story is going. If I'm not mistaken, this is supposed to be a continuation of the original series and not a total reboot. So just wait and see on that. I'm not 100% sure, but I think that's what's actually happening. Hopefully with the next trailer before it comes out in July, we'll get a little bit more story context. And then we can, you know, make some assumptions on where the story might go based on that. So, yeah, seeing that there's not really much more to say, thank you guys for stopping by and watching. I hope you have a fantastic day further, and I'll speak to you guys again soon. Bye for now.